This is the Raspberry Pi 3 motion detection camera. It's running MotionEyeOS from a 16GB SD card. There is a USB flash drive also inserted into the USB port. It's used to record images and videos from this 5 megapixels night vision camera module. There is a 12V cooler attached to the casing of the Raspberry Pi, and this is the circuit for turning it on or off. The main power supply is this AC to DC 12V power supply. The cooler can also work at lower voltages. The Raspberry Pi itself is powered by this 5V buck converter, which can be turned on or off by this circuit, which I made using Arduino Pro Mini. And when there is no power available from the main power supply, everything is powered by this battery pack, which I have made using these pairs of nickel metal hydride cells. They are rated at 2.4 volts and 1300 milliamp hours. Their voltage at full charge is 2.8 volts. This circuit also connects to the Raspberry Pi's GPIOs, but the connection is not electrical. Instead, I have used two optical isolators to signal the Raspberry Pi to shut down and get a signal back from the Raspberry Pi if it is running or not. Same optical isolator is used in the circuit for turning the cooler on or off. The circuit connects to the power supply and the battery here. The 12 volts positive wire from the power supply connects here and the battery here. And they go to this bridge rectifier, which has four diodes inside, like this. The positive wire goes here and the battery here, and through individual diodes they go to the output pin. Whichever has the higher voltage will go to the output pin of the bridge rectifier, and through there to the 12 volts cooler, the voltage regulator and the buck converter. This is the 5 volts regulator. It is used to power the Arduino, and the buck converter only powers the Raspberry Pi and infrared LEDs, which I have not connected right now. The battery voltage is measured by Arduino's analog pin using this voltage divider circuit with its R1 connected to the pin of the bridge rectifier where the positive wire from the battery is connected. So if there is no power and the battery voltage goes below a level which is set in the sketch running on the Arduino Pro Mini, Arduino's GPIO pin turns on, turning on the optical isolator, and on the other side the Raspberry Pi GPIO reads a low and it shuts down. After that the Arduino starts a timer, and when the timer is up it turns off this n-channel MOSFET, cutting the power to the buck converter. Because the buck converter's negative wire is connected to the drain pin of the n-channel MOSFET, and n-channel MOSFET's source pin is connected to the common ground, where the power supply is negative and the battery is negative, connect to each other. This is the MOSFET that I have used. It's FQP30N06L. L stands for logic, and this MOSFET works at 5 volts. Its source pin is connected to the common ground, where the power supply unit and the battery pack's negative wire is connected to each other. The negative wire from the buck converter connects here to the drain pin of the MOSFET, and through here it goes to the ground. The gate pin of the MOSFET is pulled low by a 100k resistor, 100,000 ohms resistor, to the ground, and is connected via a 1000 ohms or 1k resistor to Arduino's GPIO. So when the GPIO goes high, the MOSFET turns on and allows the flow of current from the negative wire of the buck converter to the ground. Arduino is powered by the 5 volts voltage regulator, and is connected to its 5 volts output pin and ground pin. The ground pin of the regulator goes to the common ground of the power supply unit and the battery pack, and the input of the voltage regulator is connected to the bridge rectifier's output pin. Battery charging is done using this PNP transistor and this NPN transistor connected to Arduino's GPIO pin. The emitter pin of the PNP transistor is connected to the second pin of the bridge rectifier, which is directly connected to the positive wire from the 12 volts power supply. The base of the PNP transistor is connected to the positive of the power supply via a 22,000 ohms resistor. And if you ignore the rest of the circuit, in this state the PNP transistor will stay off because its base and emitter are both at the same voltage. The base is also connected via a 10k ohm resistor to the collector of the NPN transistor to form a voltage divider circuit when the NPN transistor turns on. The base of the NPN transistor via a 22,000 ohms resistor is connected to Arduino's GPIO pin. So when the GPIO goes high, the NPN transistor turns on, forms a voltage divider circuit, and the voltage drops at the base of the PNP transistor, and it also turns on, allowing the flow of current from its emitter, which is connected to the power supply, to its collector, which is connected to the fourth pin of the bridge rectifier. The current flows from its emitter to collector and then through the fourth pin of the bridge rectifier inside the third diode here, and then the current flows towards the third pin of the bridge rectifier circuit and goes to the positive wire of the battery pack, and it charges the battery. The voltage is dropped in the diode just a little, but it's enough to charge the battery. The sensing if there is power available or not is done using this optical isolator. Inside the optical isolator there is an infrared LED on the left side like this and a phototransistor on the right side. There is no electrical connection between both sides of the optical isolator. The LED side has its anode connected via a 22,000 ohms resistor to the positive of the power supply, and the ground pin is connected to the common ground. On the phototransistor side, the collector is connected to Arduino's GPIO and via a 22,000 ohms resistor to 5 volts output of the voltage regulator. Emitter is connected to common ground. When there is power available, phototransistor will conduct current and Arduino will read a low at this point. And when there is no power available, Arduino's GPIO will be high. The circuit for battery voltage measurement is just a voltage divider circuit. I have used 10,000 ohms resistor for R1 and 2.2k ohms resistor for R2. At the Vout, there is a 4.7k ohm resistor connected to analog pin of Arduino. Arduino and the Raspberry Pi communicate with each other via two optical isolators connected to the GPIO pins. One of the two isolators is used to signal the Raspberry Pi to shut down when the battery voltage is low, and the second one is used to see if Pi is currently powered up or not. The first isolator on its LED side has its anode connected to Arduino's GPIO via a 1000 ohms resistor. Its cathode is connected to ground. On the phototransistor side, the collector pin is connected via a 22,000 ohms resistor to 3.3 volts pin on Raspberry Pi's header. And the collector pin is also connected to a GPIO pin on the header. When Arduino's GPIO is low, which will happen normally, the collector pin will have a 3.3 volts voltage level and the GPIO will read a high. When Arduino's GPIO goes high, the phototransistor will start conducting current, and the current will flow towards the ground. The voltage level here will drop, and the bash script running on the Raspberry Pi will read a low at this GPIO pin, and then it will shut down. The second isolator has its LEDs anode connected via a 500 ohms resistor to the GPIO pin on the Raspberry Pi, and on the phototransistor side, the collector is pulled up to 5 volts via 22,000 ohms resistor and is connected to Arduino's GPIO pin. Arduino will read a high when Pi is powered off, and when the Pi is working, it will read a low. Finally, the circuit for switching the cooler fan using Raspberry Pi's GPIO and its internal temperature. I have used an NPN transistor BC337 as a low side switch. The positive wire of the cooler fan is connected to the positive 12 volts power supply, and the negative wire is connected to the collector pin of the first transistor. Its emitter pin is connected to ground. Because it works at lower voltages than the power supply's voltage, I have used a voltage divider circuit using a 2.2k resistor and a 1k resistor. Vout is 3.75 volts and via a 2.2k resistor, the base is pulled up to it. The second transistor is 2N3904 with its collector pin connected to the first transistor's base, and its base is pulled up via a 10k resistor. When the first transistor is connected in the circuit, it turns on and it turns on the fan with it. The second transistor keeps the first transistor off, and to turn on the fan, the second transistor must be turned off. Using an optical isolator with its collector pin connected to the base of the second transistor and the anode of optical isolator connected to Raspberry Pi's GPIO via a 2.2k resistor, the Raspberry Pi's GPIO turns on, optical isolator turns on, and it turns off the second transistor, turning on the fan. And when the GPIO goes low, the fan turns off. Now I have connected Arduino to a PC using a USB to serial converter. And in the serial monitor, Arduino is showing that power is available, charging is on, load is off, and battery voltage is 10.70 volts. It has a countdown timer, after which the load is, after that timer is up, the load will turn on, because the battery voltage is above the load on voltage. If I remove the wire from the main power supply now, the timer will stop and it will not turn the load on. I have removed the wire. Arduino will detect that there is no power available, and it's showing that there is no power available. It has stopped the timer, and it will not turn the load on in this state. Now I have inserted the wire again, and it's showing that power is available. It has started the timer where it had left it, and after the timer is up, it will turn the n-channel MOSFET on. Now only 20 seconds are left. After that time is up, the load, which is this buck converter connected to the Raspberry Pi, will turn on. The load has turned on. The buck converter is now on, and the Raspberry Pi is booting up. Camera has also turned on, and it's recording videos. It takes a few seconds for the Raspberry Pi to turn on its GPIO, and Arduino is now showing that the Pi has turned on. Otherwise, if the Pi is not on, Arduino starts a reset timer, and after that, it will reset the Raspberry Pi. It's useful if you power off the Raspberry Pi, the Arduino resets it and powers it back up again. Now in this state, when the Raspberry Pi is working, I'll remove the power from main power supply.
and you can see that it's still working on battery power. Arduino is showing that there is no power available and it has started another timer. If the timer is up and there is no power available, it will signal the Raspberry Pi to shut down. But if the voltage drops first below a certain level, below Pi off voltage in the sketch, it will signal the Raspberry Pi to shut down according to that voltage level. And if the power comes back again and Raspberry Pi is off, it will reset it and it will turn it back on again. All the settings are in the sketch. I'll put all the links in the description. Please like and subscribe. Bye.